I'm Chris Hassel. This is the Super Bowl Props Hour. We're going to get you winning picks from Sportsline experts. I've got a couple for you right now. I'm being told that the number one Sportsline-backed prop is Tyreek Hill, over 94.5 receiving yards. And if you want a prop that's 100-1 that some of our experts are backing, go to sportsline.com right now and join. Want to let you know that we have a prop contest going on at cbssports.com right now. Want to win $1 million? Well, enter this. It's your chance with football props from CBS Sports. You can get in the action today. Compete for the $1 million jackpot with another $50,000 guaranteed going to the winner. Go to cbssports.com/props or scan the QR code on your screen with your mobile device to play right now. And right now, I am joined by a couple of our best men, Sportsline's Emery Hunt, and also William Hill, Director of Trading, Nick Bogdanovich. Nick, it's a year unlike any other in this Super Bowl 55. What has the money been like? What has the betting been like compared to years past?
I'd say it's a slight touch behind, but, you know, that can change. The majority of the money comes in the last 3 days anyway, so... But, you know, it's business as usual. They're betting the props with both hands. Right now, it's Kansas City minus the points is about 70% of the bets. Over is about 65% of the bets. And Tampa Bay on the money line is about 65% of the bets. So it's pretty much standard operating procedure. We're gonna need the favorite to win the game, not cover, and the game to go under. That's pretty much who we need every Super Bowl.
Yeah, I'm just excited to see both teams get out here and play. I think both offenses are really at their best of the season so far. The defenses are starting to come along. So we should see a high-scoring, very good competitive contest go back and forth in this one.
And one of the highest over-unders of all time at 56.5. Nick, let us in on the process behind filling out the prop card at William Hill.
Yeah, no, it's hard. Obviously, we go through last year and the year before and try to eliminate any ones that didn't draw any action. Then we try to bring in some fresh blood, which we did this year. But then it really boils down to the stars of the game. Anything Mahomes, Brady, Kelce, Tyreek, that's getting pounded, and that'll be, you know, where the majority of the money goes. But, you know, 600-700 props, you're bound to make some few mistakes. So the professionals definitely get excited this time of the year, knowing that they can feast on huge, huge menus of props.
And Emery, you've got all those props to look at. If you had to pick out one that you like to bet each and every Super Bowl, what would that be?
It'll be the first touchdown scored, and that to me is an easier one because you tend to go always with who has the best offense going into this ball game. And you look at Kansas City, I think at plus 145, that's the prop going in. Who will score the first touchdown? I just think Kansas City's offense is what we expect offense to look like in the 21st century, and I think they'll be the one to score the first touchdown.
Okay, well, let's get a little bit more specific. Go team by team here. Nick, what's the most popular Chiefs prop this week?
Involving the Chiefs, I would say Travis Kelce to score a touchdown. I think he scored in 6 or 7 straight. We opened, yes, minus 130. It's up to minus 180. So if you're looking at a Chief prop that is drawing a lot of action, look no farther than the big tight end, Travis Kelce.
You know, my favorite one is Tyreek Hill going over 28.5 yards receiving. And that's his longest reception. To me, he's a chunk play guy. This is a chunk play offense. He's their chunk playmaker. Expect him to have at least 2 of these receptions to go over 30-plus yards in this game. So I think that's an easy prop to go ahead and lock up at minus 115.
And it might not be the most popular, but as I mentioned off the top, Sportsline's number one prop right now, Tyreek Hill, over 94.5 receiving yards. Nick, let's move on to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. What's the top Bucs prop being bet right now, the most popular?
I'd have to say it'd have to be Tom Brady touchdown passes. Professionals obviously betting him under, the masses betting him over. When push comes to shove, when this game kicks off Sunday, we're going to need under 2.5 Tom Brady touchdowns for a small amount of money. So, but that one's obvious. Anything with Brady's very popular. But I'd say that right now that's the most popular Brady prop.
You know, I'm going to defensive side of the ball at plus 115. Devin White having over 10.5 tackles and assists in this game. This is a guy that averages double-digit tackles a game. He's sideline to sideline. I think a lot of it is due to his former, history as a running back going into LSU. So he understands blocking assignments. He understands what the defense is trying to do, or the offense is trying to do to the defense. So that's why he's always a step ahead of the offensive play. He'll get at least 12 tackles in his ball game when you combine solo tackles and assisted tackles.
All right, so Emery going with a little defense for his favorite Bucks prop. He said his favorite prop each and every Super Bowl is the first touchdown score. Nick, where's the money going right now on the first touchdown score of this game?
All you got to do is look at the big three. The first touchdown scored is receivers, Evans, Tyreek Hill, and Kelsey. So that's where the three leaders in the money are for a player to score first touchdown. And I believe last year Mahomes scored the first touchdown and we got barbecued. But this is year in and year out the prop we write the most tickets and most dollars on.
You know, I think Tyreek Hill will get them down the field, but I do believe the first touchdown that will be scored will be by Travis Kelce. So I think he'll get into the end zone, the short touchdown at plus 650. So I will take that one. But look for Tyreek Hill to be the one to get them down the field in position to score that first touchdown.
And if you're new to betting, just make sure you know this is touchdown score. This isn't, Patrick Mahomes throwing a touchdown. It's got to be Patrick Mahomes rushing it in for a touchdown, for him to be the first touchdown scorer. That's why the odds are so high for the quarterbacks. All right, moving on to the Super Bowl MVP, Nick. It's kind of like first touchdown score, but we know that quarterbacks dominate this award. Where is the money going for Super Bowl MVP at this point?
Yeah, this was a prop we got to start booking a few years ago due to regulations, and it's very, very popular. It almost rivals the first player to score now. Very, very popular. Right now, the most money is with Tom Brady, then Patrick Mahomes, and then Travis Kelce. Those are the three drawing the most money. Obviously, the Chiefs are $1.60 on the money line to win the game. Patrick Mahomes is minus 120. To win MVP, so, let's face it, if KC wins the game, chances are Mahomes will be the MVP. That's why he's drawing the money.
I totally agree with you, Nick. I don't care if Tyrann Mathieu has 7 interceptions and Chris Jones have 15 sacks. Pat Mahomes will win the MVP because he led them to those 7 interceptions and 15 sacks. So laying all that money with Pat Mahomes to win the Super Bowl MVP if they win the game.
Yeah, it's weird. About 5-6 years ago, a couple of defensive guys won it, but you take those out of the equation, and it's pretty much all quarterbacks this century for Super Bowl MVP. Nick Bogdanovich, Director of Trading at William Hill, thank you so much for joining us here on our props special, our super prop special. Want to recap some of Emery's early picks here as we, it's not early in the week anymore. I guess we're Thursday, just a few days away from the game. He likes the Chiefs to score the first touchdown. Tyreek Hill, longest reception, over 27.5 yards. White, over 10.5 total tackles. That's combined. So you get assists there as well. He thinks he'll go 12 or 13. Kelce to score the first touchdown and Mahomes to win Super Bowl MVP. He's not screwing around with that one. Hey, if you want to win $1 million, this is your chance. Football props from CBS Sports. Football props 100% free to play. Just download the CBS Sports app. Go to cbssports.com/props or scan the QR code on your screen with your mobile device and play it right now. We are going to continue on picking props, and we're looking at the quarterbacks up next. The top props for Patrick Mahomes and Tom Brady as we continue to be joined by Sportsline's best. CBS Sports HQ presented by Body Armor Light, more than a sports drink. I'm Chris Hassel. I am joined on set here in Tampa by Danny Cannell. We are also joined by a couple of Sportsline's finest, Emery Hunt and Larry Hartstein. And we are going to get into some quarterback props right now. Let's start with Patrick Mahomes. Over-under for touchdowns is 2.5. A lot of people diving in on the rushing yards total as well at 21.5. Emery, I'll let you lead us off with your favorite Patrick Mahomes prop this week.
Yeah, I'm pulling up from half court with this one. At plus 450, he will throw 4 touchdowns in this game. That's what got them here. That's what get them the Super Bowl victory, and that's what will get me this prop, because I do think Pat Mahomes will work touchdown to check down against that secondary of the Bucks.
I love that one, Emery. He threw three in the regular season meeting, and he was down inside the 23 other times. They settled for field goals, and there was a fumble there. So I love him over 2.5. I'm not going to go for the 4 touchdowns. I'm just going to take him over 2.5. You can't run the ball against Tampa Bay with Vita Vea back in the lineup. 2.7 yards a carry. I think they get 3 or 4 touchdowns. I think they all come through the air. And I'll give you a bonus prop. That rushing yards is down to 21.5 for Patrick Mahomes. I think his toe is almost 100%. It probably will be 100% by game time. The narrative is that he's not going to run. I think this number is too low. And one other stat, the Bucs, second worst in the league at defending quarterback runs.
I love it, Larry. That's exactly where I was going. And it was 22.5, and I liked it there. I love it at 21.5. You mentioned the toe. Even if it is still an issue, he's not going to feel it if it is. They'll take care of that with whatever injection they can so that he doesn't. We know that they're going to try to get after Patrick Mahomes with a pass rush with a depleted offensive line, but Patrick Mahomes is mobile. He could get this in just one scramble. We've seen him do it before. And in the Super Bowl, you tend to put your body on the line a little bit more. You don't go out of bounds. You get the extra yard. So I'm going to take the over as well.
Yeah, we've seen him, especially in big games, using those legs and picking up big yardage and big first downs. But I gotta side with Emery on this one. I mean, he pulling up half court,
yes,
just turning around like Swaggy P. He knows it's going in. Plus 450 for Patrick Mahomes to throw 4 touchdown passes. Let's move on to Tom Brady. Emery, are you digging deep into the props for this one, or are you going more standard here with Brady?
Nah, I'm getting a special on the menu. I'm going minus 200. His first pass will be a completion. I couldn't go aggressive with this one. This one, to me, Brady finds completions in football games. He will find a lot of completions, I believe, because I think they'll score a lot of points. So his first pass will definitely be a completion.
I'm going chalk as well, but not quite that much chalk. Minus 170 now for Brady to throw over 0.5 interceptions. And we saw him throw 3 in the second half last week. And he loves to throw it up for grabs. It's like a punt to Mike Evans and Chris Godwin going up against a secondary that has 18 picks this year. The Honey Badger has 7 all by himself. I'm betting Brady to throw at least 1 pick.
All right, he might, but I also think he's going to put up a bunch of yards. I'm going to take the over 305.5 passing yards for Tom Brady. This is going to be a shootout. We saw it in the regular season matchup where Mahomes went off well over 450, but we also saw Brady above 335 as well. So I think he clears this number easily, and I do think there'll be some back and forth. So even if the game isn't close, we know the Bucs aren't going to give up. We know they'll have to go to the air. That's what they do. So I'm going to take the over Tom Brady passing yardage total.
All right, those are our favorite quarterback props here on our prop special. We're going to get to the pass catchers a little bit later in this hour-long prop special, but let's get to the running backs. And Leonard Fournette, a guy who they call him Playoff Lenny now. I mean, he's 5-1 record straight up in playoff games, and he's averaging over 100 yards from scrimmage in the 3 playoff wins this season. Emery, what's your favorite Fournette prop?
There's a lot of disrespectful running back props in this game, and the most disrespectful one for me, seeing that his first carry would be over under 3.5 yards. Smash that over. He's going to go over that number. I think he can fall forward and get 4 yards. So I do think his first carry will be over 3.5 yards. Again, the run defense for Kansas City isn't the best. So I do think he'll go over that number with the first carry. It's just so disrespectful.
I'm going to look at his receiving yards prop. He's become the primary receiving back, 13 targets the last 2 weeks. The number's only 26.5. And you look at the Chiefs, they give up more receiving yards to running backs than any other team in the league. Go over 26.5.
Anytime you get a nickname like Playoff Lenny, I think that's the time to sell. That's like peak Leonard Fournette. So I'm going to look just at the rushing total. It's at 49.5. I know he's coming in here with a lot of buzz, and he's been great through the playoffs, but I think they'll spread around through him. I think he might get some pass catches. And the run game itself, I think they'll hold him in check. And I don't think they're going to be featuring the run game that much. Yes, to sprinkle in there to keep Kansas City's defense honest, but I don't think you see a massive game from Leonard Fournette on the ground. So I'm going to take the under 49.5 Fournette rushing yards.
Larry, we're not going to go deep into Ronald Jones. I just wanted to ask you, is there any value in looking at any Ronald Jones prop this weekend?
I'd look under. I mean, the guy got 16 snaps compared to 41 for Fournette. We see where it's going. So I'd look under.
Okay, let's move on to the Chiefs and Clyde Edwards-Helaire and his props. Another guy who just hasn't really been there the last several games. It's another running back who's taken the low, but Clyde Edwards-Helaire was a great running back for about a month in the regular season. Emery, do you think he is going to go over most of these props or go under?
The disrespect continues. Again, 3.5 over under his first rush in this game. I'm smashing the over. People will talk about Vita Vey, big mammoth defensive tackle right there in the middle, number one rush defense. I get all of that. Here's how you can run the football when you have that much going on in the middle. You run outside. You're going to see a lot of influence with motion, ghost motion going behind Pat Mahomes. They'll have a crack toss involved. His first carry will not be run dead smack into the middle of Vita Vey's stomach. It'll be run to the outside. He'll get 4 yards on that first carry he touches.
You look at these totals, it's come down from 30.5 to 28.5, and I think justifiably so. You got three running backs to split between. The last time he played, he rushed 6 times for 7 yards. You're going against a pass funnel defense. You cannot run against this Tampa defense, so I'm going under 28.5.
I'm going under the Clyde Edwards-Helaire total between rushing and receiving yards at 53.5. Totally agree with you, Larry. And I also think, I mean, he's been injured. We don't know where he is. He's missed a lot of time. Who are you going to trust here? I think you're going to go with what got you there. And it has been Clyde Edwards-Helaire, who's been on the sidelines with this hip injury. I think you're going to see a sprinkle of him, but not a featured back in this game. So I'm going to take the under.
Yeah, last year it was Damian Williams, who darn near won Super Bowl MVP. Maybe this year it's Darrell Williams. He's been the bell cow back for the Chiefs in the postseason. Let's move on to a special prop to target. I'm just going to throw it out there to you, Emery. What is a special prop? I feel like I've already gotten one or two from you in this first half hour of the show, but what's the special prop you're looking at?
You know, I look at the Gatorade toss at the end of the game. You know, what color would it be? I think that's a pretty cool prop. If I'm going to go plus 500, it'll be water. I think they'll take the easy route because usually players drink a lot of water during the game, so that would be the least heaviest one to carry over to coach and get it up over and dump it on his head. So I think water will be what will be thrown on the coach for whoever wins the game.
Well, I like this one about what are the announcers going to mention first? The fact that this is Tom Brady's 10th Super Bowl or his age, 43, and I think they're going to say 10th Super Bowl almost right from the go. It's only a minus 180 favorite where I've seen it. So that's my play.
I'm a golf nut. I love the PGA Tour, and I found a great pop, Brett, between the receptions of Leonard Fournette versus John Rahm. How many birdies does he get in his final round at the Waste Management Open? It's in Phoenix. It's where Rahm went to college at Arizona State. He's playing in front of his home crowd. I think he runs away with this an easy one. Even though he's given a half, I think he gets a ton of birdies in his final round. I don't think you see that much out of Fournette. So I'm going to take John Rahm. Even though it's a little bit expensive at minus 120, I still think it's going to hit.
I'm going to put you on the spot here, Danny, because I haven't been following golf this week, but I did follow a little bit over the weekend. Is Patrick Reed playing this week?
I am not 100% sure.
Okay, because if he is, is there an embedded ball prop?
There should be. Or does he cheat in some capacity? And I would take the yes.
All right, Larry Hartstein, stick around. Emery Hunt, thank you so much for your time here on CBS Sports HQ as we get you our favorite props for Super Bowl Sunday. We do want to let you know that we have a contest going on. It's football props, CBSSports.com with the CBS Sports app. You can win $1 million. You could win $500,000. Just open your camera, scan the code, enter to win big bucks, and it's free. All right, so we picked quarterback props, running back props. How about some pass catching props? And we've got two of the best tight ends to ever do it, Rob Gronkowski and Travis Kelce. We'll pick those next. This hour of CBS Sports HQ brought to you by Body Armor Light. More than a sports drink. I'm Chris Hassel, joined here in Tampa by Danny Cannell. We are also joined now by the Wizard of Odds, Kenny White. Larry Hartstein is with us as well as we pick some pass catcher props. And Kenny, let's start with the Kansas City Chiefs. I think a lot of people are going to be all over Tyreek Hill. Not a lot of other pass catchers outside the tight ends that you might be zeroing in on, but what do you think?
Well, Sammy Watkins is back this week, too. That's going to be a big help for Kansas City, and he's going to take some receptions and yards away from other receivers. I think it's going to be Mecole Hardman under 29.5 yards. His median for the entire season, 26. Last 10 games, 24 yards. He's gone under this 5 of the last 6 games. So I think he's the guy that will be losing some receptions and some reps with Sammy Watkins back on the field for the Chiefs this weekend.
I'm going to look at Tyreek Hill and his explosiveness. Longest catch over 27 and a half. You go back to that first meeting, three catches longer than this, including two touchdowns. He's gone over this number in five of his last seven, 10 times all year. And the Bucs secondary gives up these plays 24 times this season. They have given up a catch this long, go over 27 and a half.
So I think we spent, I hate going against Kenny, but I'm actually on the opposite side of Kenny here, going Mecole Hardman over his receiving total. I think the defense is going to spend so much time worrying about Tyreek Hill, trying to contain him, put so much focus on rolling coverage that way. Sammy Watkins back. He's a name that people recognize where the role players have the opportunity. And with Mecole Hardman's speed, he could catch something in the flat and turn it upfield with his speed. He's the second fastest player on the team outside of Tyreek Hill. It might take just one catch for him to get that over for his receiving total. So I'm going to take Mecole Hardman over.
Danny, it's not fair that you got the last word there. So I want to allow our Wizard of Odds to have a little rebuttal there. Kenny, what do you think of Danny going against you here on Mecole Hardman?
You know, I can't argue because the guy's got such blazing speed. One big play, it gets over this number. I'm playing it more about, you know, what I've seen happen during the season and his meet with his median numbers all being below this, and then knowing Sammy Watkins will be back this week with his experience. Also, you know, the Chiefs have confidence in Hardman, but that muff punt last week, you know, that's a little shaky for him, a little scary for the Kansas City Chiefs. I don't know, I think he was one of the guys that right now he's not practicing maybe, or no, wasn't Hardman, it's the other receiver. Was in the haircut situation, the close call. So it wasn't Hardman, but I think he's really the third receiver. And you know, Danny's right though. They are going to try to pay special attention to Hill, but they know they can't take it away. I think Tampa's defense is good enough though, and they're improved. They're number five against the pass in DVOA, and that's for the entire season, really without Vita Vey. They get Vita Vey back in the lineup, he's going to be able to stop the run. They don't have to blitz as much. Their pass defense gets that much better.
Yeah, it was Robinson that was out in the COVID protocol, but it looks like he's going to be able to give it a go. And Sammy Watkins sounds like he's trending in the right direction as well. I guess only in the last year can you reference a haircut situation as we lead up to the Super Bowl just a few days away. Let's move on to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the wide receiver props there. Kenny, there's a lot of places to go because they have so many great weapons at Tom Brady's disposal.
You're right about that. And, you know, I'm going to always be looking for unders because these numbers are all overinflated. When you add up all the numbers from all the receiving yards, it's like 375. And we know that he's not going to, it's a little exaggeration, but it's well over what Tom Brady is supposed to pass for. So everybody's overinflated. And the big thing is Antonio Brown playing in this game. I think he's playing. I think he's on the field. Sportsbooks would not be putting up 3.5 receptions, 42 and a half yards for Antonio Brown if he wasn't playing. If they were unsure of his status, there'd be no wagering on him. So with him in the lineup, that takes away receiving yards and receptions from Mike Evans. And Mike Evans' numbers on the year, 53 yards is his median receiving yards. 62 and a half is the number. I'm going to go under here. I think the Buccaneers are going to try to run and exploit that defense that's ranked 31st. In the NFL, that's the chief defense against the run more than they will passing game in this game.
Kenny, I totally agree with you on Mike Evans. I think this is going to be a huge Chris Godwin game. If you go back to that first meeting, you look at the first half, they were throwing outside. They had no success. The Chiefs' outside corners are very good. Second half, they started hammering the slot. And what did Godwin finish? 8 catches, 97 yards. He has 28 targets in the playoffs. He's only caught 14 of them, which is kind of an anomaly. His number is only 5.5 catches. That's value there. I think he's definitely going to get 6. And I love his receiving yards. Over 74.5.
And that was Pete Prisco's top prop, over 5.5 receptions. He loves it. He's telling everybody about it. He wants everybody to get rich.
He does. He does want him. I'm going to try to help him, too. I'm going to look at who Kenny mentioned. Antonio Brown is going to play. I think he will, too. But I don't think he plays that well. I think there will be a lingering issue there. So even if he does play, how long can he play? How critical a part of this offense will he be with the weapons that I have there? Because I do think Godwin will be a featured player in this game. I do think Brady will go to his favorite target, Mike Evans, frequently. I don't think Antonio Brown is going to be a critical component in this game. He's a big name. You know, people know who he is, but that doesn't mean he's going to get production in this game. So I'm going to take under 43.5 yards for Antonio Brown.
Okay, so those are our favorite wide receiver props in this game, but the best players might be the pass catchers who are also blockers, the tight ends. Two of the best tight ends in history, although Rob Gronkowski is not the Rob Gronkowski he was, say, 5, 6, 7, 10 years ago. But Kenny, talk about Travis Kelce and his props. You're getting a little loosey-goosey on us on this one. You're going with a double. What do you have?
Yeah, well, you know, the number on Kelce is pretty high. I think it's 97.5 yards. I think it's going to come close. My projection was 95.5 on Kelce, so I'm right there. But that 95 yards, I have Kelce with the most receiving yards of any player in the Super Bowl. Well, I also have Tom Brady, my projection. Actually, I have Tom Brady throwing for 5 more yards in this game than Patrick Mahomes, because I have Tom Brady with more pass attempts than Mahomes in the game. So I'm going to use Kelce receiving yards as the top receiving yards of any player, and Tom Brady's most passing yards of any player. And I get 8-1 on that that prop. I think that's a nice prop.
I'm going to keep it simple. Travis Kelce to score a touchdown. 6 straight games, he scored a touchdown. Last week, 2 touchdowns. His last 8 playoff games, 8 touchdowns. This guy is going to be a huge focus. He did not score in the first meeting. Of course, Tyreek Hill dominated. There's going to be a lot of focus on Tyreek Hill. Travis Kelce is getting in the end zone.
I love it, Larry. I'm going to go along with you with Travis Kelce, but I'm going to go in a little bit different direction with the yardage total at 96.5. This guy's a machine. The Bucs' weakness has been in the secondary, covering tight ends, and you're talking about trying to stop one of the best in the game. And I think their focal point will be to prevent Tyreek Hill from giving up that deep ball, which presents a lot of catches opportunity for Travis Kelce underneath. I think the yardage will start to add up, and he'll easily go over the 96.5.
Kelce, the best wide receiver in the game right now, but I think some would argue that Rob Gronkowski has had the better career start to finish. We're going to discuss that a little bit more later on in the week. Right now, we're sticking to props. Rob Gronkowski has not gotten in the end zone very often lately, Kenny. What are the props that you like for Gronk?
Yeah, I'm not going to go with a touchdown prop on him, but he had a nice 29-yard reception on a screen pass in the last game and a 14-yard reception in his only reception against the Saints. His average reception is 13.8 yards. So I'm going to go over 7.5 yards on his first reception of the game.
Well, Kenny, you mentioned those 2 catches. Those are his only catches in the playoffs. I mean, this guy is a blocking tight end at this point in his career. I know everyone loves the storyline of Brady and Gronk, but the facts are that Cameron Brate is now the main receiving tight end. Last week, his total was 29.5. He had that screen pass that was very well designed, and he took it for 29, stayed under. They lowered it a yard. I think he definitely goes under. He could catch 2 passes and still go under this number.
All right, Larry, I'm going to attack this one a little bit a different way. I'm going to take Gronk over 2.5 receptions. I think Brady likes to take care of his guy. He brought him here to Tampa. I think Brady's tired of hearing all about Travis Kelce, how he's the best tight end to play the game. I think he wants to remind people what Gronk is, and Gronk is a valuable asset once they get in the red zone. That's where I think he'll get his opportunities. I think you get maybe 1 catch in the field, 2 down closer to the red zone. So I'm going to take over 2.5 catches for Gronk.
We are getting more and more props for regular season games as we move into the 21st century now, into the 2021, 2022. But in the Super Bowl, it's just a little bit better because there's just a little bit more. How about a favorite non-football prop? And Kenny, I know a lot of people love the coin toss prop. I'm guessing you're going to say don't touch it unless it's less than, -115 or -110. Is that right?
We got to know the weight of the, well, it's -101 either way, because the books feel, hey, it's a 50% prop. So they're going to make money and it'd probably be well balanced. But I those coins that they flip, these are big coins, and there's a difference in weight on the head side of the coin, and tails comes up more. And there you go. Look at all the tails there. 6-2, 75% of the time. Give me tails never fails at -101.
There's a big cross sport prop that I really love, Chris, and it is Villanova laying 13.5 points against the total points scored in the Super Bowl. Villanova's playing Georgetown. Villanova averages 77 a game. Georgetown gives up 77 a game. Villanova coming off that terrible 59-point performance against St. John's. Let's say they score 75. If this game ends at 61 total points, which is 5 points higher than the current total, you still cash that bet. That's my favorite cross prop of the day.
All right, I got one that I know Chris Hassel is going to absolutely love because he's huge into crypto. All right, so Bitcoin has been all the trend. It's been up past 40,000. It's hovering around 37,000 right now. Will it rise during the Super Bowl? I'm going to say yes. And so the odds makers think so too. It's at minus 150. But if you watch it, which I do, typically during the weekend, it does kind of gain some traction. Sundays it frequently goes up. And I think it goes up during the Super Bowl as well. So Bitcoin will rise during the Super Bowl.
I have no idea what makes Bitcoin rise or fall. I just know that it's either all coming crashing down or Bitcoin is through the roof. It's never like in the middle.
Bitcoin to a million.
Rising during the Super Bowl,
yep.
Right? Okay. All right. I love it. Okay, guys. Thank you so much, Larry, Kenny. I do want to let you know that we have a prop contest on CBSSports.com that is absolutely free. It's a chance for you to win $1 million. It's football props. All you have to do is scan that code. You know how to do that by now. If you've gone out to a restaurant in the last year, everything is with the QR code now. All the menus are like that. Do that. Enter to win. You could be our big winner. All right, coming up next, we're talking defense. And we're talking to the Hammer. Hammer and Hank Goldberg joins us next on HQ. Super Bowl 55 has all the makings of an all-time classic. Tampa Bay becoming the first team in history to host a Super Bowl thanks to Tom Brady, who returns for a 10th time looking to win an unprecedented 7th ring.
Really, for me as a player, just ended up being a great fit. As it's played out, you know, I just thought, wow, this has really been a magical year.
For TB12 to get number 7, he knows the Bucs will have to be at their absolute best to knock off the defending champion Kansas City Chiefs. While eclipsing Brady's accolades seem out of the reach for most, if there's someone who is capable, it's Patrick Mahomes.
Being able to go up against one of the greatest, if not the greatest, quarterback of all time in his 150th Super Bowl, I mean, it's going to be a great experience for me.
The 25-year-old is already putting together a Hall of Fame resume and is one game from leading his team to back-to-back titles, something no quarterback has done since Tom Brady back in 2003 and 2004. The greatest ever facing the greatest right now. But this game may very well come down to an unlikely hero coming up big when it matters most. Who will shine on the biggest stage in sports? The drama awaits on CBS. And we're only 3 days away. HQ presented by Body Armor Light. More than a sports drink. The sun setting on Thursday evening in Tampa. The best day of the week so far. The wind has died down, but the rain might be coming. I am Chris Hassel. Pleased to be joined by Danny Cannell. And Danny, I'm going to let you do the honors to welcome in our next guest.
Oh, this is such a pleasure of mine. This is the highlight of my career to bring in a legend in the business, Hank the Hammer Goldberg. I'm telling you, Chris, I used to ride around the car with my dad, and I'd be like, Dad, I want to listen to LL Cool J or Salt-N-Pepa. This is in the 90s. And my dad was like, nope, we are listening to the Hammer. Grew up listening to him all the time on the radio. It is such a pleasure to be joined by the Hammer. Hammer, how are we doing?
I thought I was here to vouch for the fact that you were a great athlete at one time because I saw you.
Hey, Hammer, look, you've been doing it a long time, and you've been in this gambling thing long before a lot of us jumped in late. How are you treating Super Bowl props now compared to when you started?
Well, there's a lot more than when I started. You know, I started with Super Bowl II, and there really weren't any props at that time. But the props caught on, and you know what helped that was the start of the talk shows originating from the game. I actually was the first, along with Eddie Andelman from Boston and Doug Krikorian from L.A., to do our talk shows from the side of the Super Bowl. We were in New Orleans 1 year. And so I've had a lot of experience with this game in a lot of different areas. But I think what really turned me on to the props was when I was working with Jimmy the Greek, and he was close with Al Davis. And we used to have dinner with Al Super Bowl week every year. And I got a lot of good information out of Al, which helped me handicap the game.
About a half century ahead of his time, Hank Goldberg has been doing this longer than many of us have been alive. How about the Patrick Mahomes passing yards prop, Hank? It's 332 and a hook right now. What do you like on that?
I got in at 327 and a half. It keeps going up. But they're going to have the ball in the air. And I think that Mahomes has enough targets that you guys have been talking about that I think he'll go over. They will, I think, have some difficulty running against the defense of Tampa Bay. And I think their only chance to do anything in this game is for Mahomes to make the big plays.
I totally agree. He has so many weapons out there on the field with him. And Tampa likes to blitz. They're going to try to pressure him. But when they do, that presents opportunity on the outside. And Mahomes is at a point in his career. He talked about it this week. He feels more and more comfortable reading defenses. You will not catch him by surprise. And he's mobile. He can get out of the pocket. Look at what he did last year in the third and long. Bought himself just a little bit out of more time. Converted on that one, and the rest was history when they went on to win the Super Bowl when he converted that first down. So I'm going to take the over as well. I love what you're thinking.
Great tight end matchup in this one. Rob Gronkowski past his prime, but Travis Kelce is right in at the best tight end in the league. 7.5 receptions is the over-under, Hank.
I like the over in that. Kelce is a guy who is probably as good a receiving end as tight end as there is in the business right now. And I think if you're looking for a weakness on the other side, that's defending tight ends. So I think Kelce will easily, well, not easily, 7.5. I actually had to go 8.5. But I think Kelce will catch a lot of balls because he's going to be able to bail out his quarterback, and he'll get open, and he'll get open underneath. And so I like that. I like that prop.
Agreement again, and it's not because my dad said I wasn't welcome in my own house if I didn't agree with the hammer, but you make some great points. They're going to try to get after Patrick Mahomes. When they blitz, a lot of times the hot receiver, the guy that's open the quickest that Patrick Mahomes can go to if there's a free blitzer, is his tight end. So I think Kelce's going to get a tremendous amount of opportunities in that blitz game, but also this is the Bucs' biggest weakness is in the middle of the field. They struggle defending the tight ends, and I don't think that's going to all of a sudden cure itself versus one of the best tight ends to ever take the field.
All right, how about Mike Evans, Hank? He's been pretty quiet in the playoffs, at least the last couple of games for Tampa Bay. 4.5 receptions is the over-under.
I think Mike Evans is a cinch to catch more than 4.5 passes in the game because Brady looks to him, particularly in the red zone, because he can use his long arms against defensive backs to make receptions. And he's a key receiver. So, I mean, it's not that Brady doesn't have any other guys to throw to, but Evans is his key guy and has been all year. And I think a healthy Evans makes for a healthy ball movement. So I like Evans a lot. I think this is probably as good a prop as you're going to find.
Tom Brady has developed a tremendous amount of trust in Mike Evans. He's always open. Even if there's a defensive back that's right on his hip, you've got a massive size advantage where Brady trusts him. He can put it up high, especially in the red zone, or once they even cross midfield, he's going to take a couple shots to him, and I think Mike Evans will come down with those.
Okay, let's go to pick to score first touchdown. A lot of people are going to go chalk here with either Hill or Kelce, but Hammer and Hank is digging deep into the bag of tricks here. Hammer, who do you like to score the first touchdown in this game?
I love this play. I always used to play tight ends. Kenny Stabler and I had Novacek one year when he dropped the pass. And I said, oh, my gosh, we have him at 10-1. He said, they're going to go right back to him because the defense won't expect him to because he dropped the last one. And sure enough, Novacek was the target on the next pass by Troy, and he catches the next one. And Kenny and I had a few drinks after that. But I think that this time I'm looking for a good payoff. And I like Clyde Hilaire, whatever his last name is. He's got two last names. But Edwards-Hilaire, there's two ways that he can beat you. with a scoring play, either running or receiving. And I think that he would be a guy who could give you a decent payoff. The tight ends in this game are no value. They're a favorite on either side. So I'm going to go for Edwards-Helaire.
I'm going to go with the guy around the same aspect right there and go with Chris Godwin, where he is, because I think he's going to have a big game, too, in that opportunity. See him sitting there at plus 1,200. I love the value play here, too. We know he's going to get a lot of opportunity. I think there's some pretty good value on that one. I totally agree. The tight, like Travis Kelce at plus 650, there's no value there.
Okay, let's recap the picks from Hammer and Hank as far as player props go. And, boy, he's had a few free drinks. Or drinks well-earned, I guess, after Super Bowls in years past. This Super Bowl number 55, but he likes Mahomes to go over the passing yardage total. He said he actually got it at 327, though, so he was ahead of the game. Travis Kelce over 7.5 receptions. Evans over 4.5, loves that one. And Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Two last names, two ways to score, running and catching. Let's move on to some defensive props in this game. Hammer, how about the over-under for sacks in this game? It's set at 4.
I got over 3. I don't know where you guys are playing, but I seem to be shopping well anyway. four is a little more difficult, but you know, the ball's going to be in the air quite a bit in this game, and I like over for sacks. You've got all those 6 defensive guys for Tampa Bay are going to be all over Mahomes, and they're going to get to him more than once. And Mahomes, who likes to buy time with his movement and the offensive backfield, may not find a lot of room to move around. I think that's going to be a difference. And as far as Brady is concerned, remember last week, he had a lot of pressure on him. And that's one area where at least Kansas City on defense has a couple of guys who can rush the passer. So I'll go over.
I'm going to go the other way, Hank. I'm going to go with the under here on the 4 sacks because I do think they'll probably have to come all against Patrick Mahomes. I think Brady has done an outstanding job. This offensive line has done a fantastic job, one of the best offensive lines up front protecting him. And he also protects himself. And in this type of game, he will not hesitate to throw the ball away, to get it out of his hands, to keep himself in good yardage situations. And Patrick Mahomes, I know there's been a lot of talk about his toe and his turf toe and the fact that they are going to try to pressure him, but he is elusive and he's a guy who can escape some of that pressure. And again, in this type of game, the quarterbacks realize the importance of field position. They will not hesitate to throw the ball away. So I'll take the under.
You know, I think there's a key here, and that is with Schwartz out and with Fisher out, two offensive tackles, and they're juggling the offensive line. And you've got a lot of, that Tampa Bay team loves to blitz, and eventually they're going to get to them.
I was going to ask you guys about failed extra points, which is the only interesting thing about extra points is that you can bet on them. They both like yes for the failed extra point at plus 220. We do want to, what, we got to recap these picks, Marone, or are we going to just get right to the props here? All right. We got the prop challenge on CBSSports.com. It is free to enter. You can win $1 million. Football props, just open your camera, scan the code. You can also use the app or go to CBSSports.com, enter to win. It is absolutely free. The Super Bowl is on CBS this Sunday, Super Bowl 55. Game kicks off a little after 6:30 Eastern time, but Danny, we've got a ton of pregame coverage for you beginning at 2. I want to say thanks to Hank Goldberg, Cameron Hank, Larry Hartstein, Kenny White, Emery Hunt, Nick Bogdanovich, and Danny Cannell. Pete Prisco's standing by. He's going to be joining the set in just a little bit as the sun sets here in Tampa 3 days from the Super Bowl. Thanks for watching, everybody.